Outlaw, a KXAN investigative project. Our team is looking at the connection between a 50-year-old state law banning homosexual conduct and the record number of legislative proposals introduced in 2023 impacting LGBTQ+ Texans. The debate surrounding many of those bills focused on children and families. Some passed into law, some are challenged in court, and others are bound to resurface in future sessions. One bill that progressed through the full Senate and a House committee but ran out of time at the end of the session would have shielded attorneys expressing religious views, including stances on LGBTQ+ issues. KXAN's Daniel Marin learned some call it religious protections and others say it's a license to discriminate.
That's right, and because the proposal made it so far in the legislative process, those against it worry it could bubble up in future sessions, and those in support hope it does.
They're very different in some ways and very similar in some ways.
Houston attorney Neil Giles is the father of twins. Both attend the University of Texas.
They're both extremely smart.
And both identify as non-binary. On this weekend, Giles is in Austin to celebrate the twins' 21st birthday.
My name is Neil Giles.
A stark contrast to his visit back in February, when he testified before a Texas Senate committee against Senate Bill 559, a 2023 piece of legislation that would have expanded religious protection for attorneys in Texas for expressing their personal views on LGBTQ+ related issues. Similar proposals have popped up in the legislature before. Giles says he's worried bills like this could lead to state-sanctioned discrimination against Texans like his kids.
They already face enough hatred and oppression, and I just didn't want to see him. I didn't want to have any more of that.
The bill by East Texas Republican Brian Hughes was labeled a preemptive action to keep the State Bar of Texas from adopting a rules change made by the American Bar Association. You see, in 2016, the American Bar expanded its definition of professional misconduct to include harassment or discrimination on the basis of sexual orientation or gender identity, among others. The Texas Bar declined comment for this story.
Lawyers are being attacked and they're being threatened. They're being told unless they agree a certain way on certain political or sexuality issues that they're going to be punished. So they're actually, the Christian attorneys are the ones that are under attack.
Jonathan Sines is the president of the conservative, faith-based nonprofit advocacy group, Texas Values. He's also an attorney himself.
I could be talking with members of my church and giving them my opinion on these issues related to gender and sexuality. And I could be told that if I think it's wrong for men to be on women's sports or for men to be in women's bathrooms, that I could lose my bar license because someone suggests that they don't agree with that opinion or for some reason that it violates a rule.
Sines tells KXAN it's important that Texas Values advocates for conservative lawyers who may be afraid of speaking up and putting their careers on the line.
We support this bill to protect the conscience rights of legal professionals.
Jennifer Alman is the director of the Texas Catholic Conference of Bishops. She feels the state bar just shouldn't get ahead of the legislature on matters of gender ideology, since the state doesn't formally recognize gender identity.
We're concerned about those kinds of policies being adopted by bar associations around the country, and this law would be kind of a shield against that happening here in Texas.
Well, it's personal for me for a couple of reasons. My wife and I have three children, two of whom are members of the LGBTQ community.
Dallas attorney Steve Rudner calls bills like SB 559 a solution in search of a problem, since both the U.S. and Texas constitutions already offer religious protections to everyone.
The legislature has developed a really a fine skill in being discriminatory, and you can't hide the intent of this bill.
Rudner says proposals like this could also lead to unintended consequences for Texas attorneys like himself who do business in other states or large Texas firms with offices across the country.
If the state of Texas decided to allow lawyers to discriminate, there's no question that that would not be looked upon kindly by other states.
Unfortunately, some people in modern times, in the last few years, are starting to refer to practice of our religious belief and standing up for what we believe as discrimination, when it is absolutely not discrimination.
People's religious beliefs are fine. I don't fault people for that. They're entitled to them, but just keep them in your church. You know, don't use them to discriminate against people. That's the way I view it.
Daniel, you mentioned similar bills have been proposed in the past in response to the American Bar Association's rule changes.
Yes, most recently in 2021 and also in 2019.
Well, what about the author of SB 559, Senator Hughes? Has he indicated whether he plans to bring this up again?
I did reach out to his office asking that very question. We did not get a response by this report. If we do, we'll of course include it in our story on our website. But during the committee hearing back in February, Senator Hughes said that this bill relates to a, quote, fundamental right. He said the First Amendment, and he said it was meant to address cancel culture. So we'll see if they give it another go, Josh.